Ladies and gentlemen, I bring you greetings from Addis Ababa, the seat of the African Union Commission, which is in Ethiopia. I'm extremely honored to be part of your conversation. I'm particularly happy to see that you are able to come together to focus on our continent, and this is very good indeed, because Africa collaborates very well with Europe. Your gathering in Bonn in Germany is indeed worthy of serious consideration of the topic and offers an opportunity to share ideas to strengthen the efforts towards a food secure Africa, which we all aspire to. The heads of state of Africa, they did commit themselves to ending hunger by 2025. And this was done in 2015. That means they gave themselves a target of 10 years. They committed themselves to tripling intra-Africa trade in agricultural commodities. And this is where we should start from. As you know, this is a bold agenda. It's a bold agenda. It seeks to transform the agricultural sector. We have to look at agribusiness, agro-industries. We have to look at a number of key areas, because this is how we can create jobs. This is how we can be able to make wealth so that our young people, whom I think you already know, they are moving towards in search of green pastures, can be able really to be absorbed. A great percentage of our young people can get jobs in agriculture, as long as agriculture is developed in a manner that is attractive. The main aspiration of the African Union is to have continental integration. So, integration at the regional level is a very big agenda in the African development process. We have regional economic communities, a number of them. We have Eastern, Southern, Western, Central, and Northern. And trade is a key pillar, because unless you really trade amongst yourselves, then you cannot integrate. So, at the African Union level, a lot of effort has been put in. The African Union Commission has been able to have development programs. They have had development commitments. They have had commitments, for example, on free trade areas. And the majority of these have already committed themselves to that, and they have moved into customs union. So trade is at the heart, of regional integration, and regional integration is a key pillar of the African Union. Africa would prefer to have responsible investment. It would prefer to see that we take care of a number of factors. For example, already in Africa, we have the majority of the farmers, 80% are small-scale farmers. Small scale is large and medium scale. So we'd like to see that this is taken into consideration. And how can it be done? It can be done if the private sector or foreign investors come in to invest in agriculture. They can work, organize the small-scale farmers, provide services, especially with regard to marketing, collective responsibility, getting them involved so that they are also uplifted. That's how we can have responsible investment. But we'd like to see more production within the continent, because Africa is capable of feeding Africa, and also it is capable of feeding the at least a big majority of the world. And we have opportunities. We have opportunities because now there is increasing market because of increased population growth. We have urbanization. It is on the increase. These are market opportunities for us. So we want to see agriculture which can really answer or be responsive to this kind of situation, and opportunities are available. According to the World Bank, as you know, the projection for Africa's agricultural growth is quite really admirable. But we want to meet that one using proper dynamics, which are going to be very responsive to the people of Africa. And the leadership in Africa is really very, very keen to see agricultural transformation as one of the key priority areas. The academia is responsible for research and development. So we want this information, want the technology, want capacity building in all aspects related to agricultural sciences, agricultural uptake, the technology uptake, which has been low in Africa. So all those are very key in our agricultural transformation agenda. Let me inform you that it would have been good if I was in the audience with you in the plenary, discussing with you and also responding some of the issues if I was there. But unfortunately, I have not been able to do that. But I have saturated a paper. I hope you have got a copy. You can see more details there. Some data is there, some information is there. And should you need more information, you can let us know. But I would like to say that you are all invited to come and visit Africa and see for yourself the potential Africa has, the people itself. Africa, in fact, is really proud of its people. Then we have also the resources, the rich resources. It's only that the climate change is now coming in, but we are trying to adapt. So I would like to say that you can come and be part and parcel of our cultural transformation agenda, but also you can help us at the African Union Commission in driving the agenda, because our continental objective is to ensure that at the country level, there is increased investment in the agricultural sector, there is intersectoral linkages, we have focus on the agricultural sector, there is employment for the young people, and also poverty is reduced because the agricultural sector offers the biggest opportunity in poverty eradication on the continent. And there then, we shall be credible collaborators, credible partners with Germany. I am remembering that I need the outcomes of this meeting so that I can be able to look at where maybe I have not been able to look, because you are economists and you are well informed. I would like to have also a share of what you have had this morning and this maybe later in the afternoon. And I wish you a very good meeting.